Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, we're going to see about what is software lists in Blob. When you have a Blob, once you deleted it, if you are not enabling a soft delete, you cannot recover it. But once you enable it, you can get the accidentally deleted objects. That is the core concept behind it. Let's try to understand it better in this video. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. So what is soft delete? As I mentioned before, let's try to understand by definition. It protects the individual blob or snapshot. So I will tell you what is a snapshot. From accidental deletes by maintaining the deleted data in the system for a specified period of time. You can specify a time period as well. You can specify you maintain it for 7 days, even if I deleted it, then you can restore it, right? So during the retention period, you can restore a soft deleted object to its state at the time it was deleted. But after the retention period, you cannot recover it, okay? That is the point that is well understood by everyone. So with this note, let us begin our today's demo. Let's launch Azure portal and let's move on to our storage account and containers. And inside the containers, I have a blob here. Now you can see here, I have two images over here and I can click on it and do the delete of this blob. So here it mentioned blobs in leased state are locked for deletion and will be skipped. So someone will be leasing it. Okay, I will come to that concept later. And folder deletion is not supported and any selected folder will be skipped. Okay, so it is not a folder. Basically in the storage account, there is no concept of folder, but we can virtually create it. That's what it said. So this is also not in our case. If an immutable policy is applied to the blobs, the blob will not be deleted. So these are the things you cannot able to delete it. Okay. And once you enable a snapshot of the blob, you can also cannot delete it. Okay. So these are the different things. Let's try to delete this blob first. Okay. Then we will understand better. Now, you can see it here. We have deleted this blob and it is removed now. So there is option to show deleted blobs. You can see the option over here, right? To see the whichever blobs are deleted. This is because we have enabled the retention policy. That's why you got seeing here. Now how to restore it? Click on it. Click on the deleted blob. Once you do undelete, then it is as simple as that. So it is restored, now it become active. So this is what a very simple method to manage your soft deletes. Like if you have deleted it, you can go and check it out, uncheck this button, then you can see the active or inactive, I mean deleted, then you can restore it. This is as simple as that. Now where this property available is, like while creating the storage account itself, we have this option. If you forget that one, then there is an option over here, right? We will see the data protection over here. Deletes. Let's wait for it. I hope the option is under data protection. I will navigate over here. So in this storage account, you have an option over here to see enable soft delete for blobs. Now I will uncheck this one. Okay, I will save this one. Now once we go back to the storage container and go to some other files here, okay, it is for all the blobs. It's not only for individual objects, so inside every blob. Now I will say, I will click on this and I will do the delete. The same prompt it appears. Okay, click on OK. Now once you see show here, it will not display the deleted blobs. So that property, the data protection, is very important in order to show the list of deleted blobs and it will return it. Once that property is disabled, then it will be immediately, the delete operation is immediately effective, that cannot be reverted back. This is the option I want to highlight it. Now there comes a concept called snapshot. What do you mean by that? Once you click on any blob or object, you have an option to do the snapshot. Snapshot is nothing but it's like a taking what is the current state. Okay, you want to take one snapshot, means if this particular blob status will be snap like a photocopy, like you are taking the current value, whatever present in this blob will be photocopied. That is the concept behind the snapshot. So you can create a snapshot here. Now we have created the snapshot of this. Okay, then you can click on it. Even you can do the delete snapshot as well. Okay, now we have created the snapshot. Now once you are deleting it, if you can see, while deleting this snapshot, this blob, it will prompt for also delete the blob snapshot. When you click on OK, what happens, it will show failure, because there is no point of having a snapshot if the main object is deleted. So you need to delete the snapshot as well by clicking on this checkbox. Otherwise you manually do the delete of this snapshot first, then you can go and delete the actual object. Okay, so this is what the concept behind soft delete. I have not enabled the soft delete, so these both objects will not appear now. It will be permanent. I hope you understand the concept behind the soft delete. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. And do remember that data is your asset.